I have a presentation. Hello, everybody. I would like to ask you a question first. So, raise your hand if the answer to this question is yes. If money did not exist, would you still get up every morning and do what you do for a living?
Yes.
Great. About 10%, that 90% of the people, according to a survey made in the US, answered no, that they would do a different job than they are doing today. So I come from the lucky club of this 10% of people that I'm doing what I really love. It took me just a second when I read this question to know that I am doing what I want. And I think that if I believed in reincarnation, I'm pretty sure that I was doing this in my previous life as well. So what do? I'm an e-commerce lover. I am a hard worker. Some of my friends would say workaholic maybe. And I really believe in knowledge. All of you have emphasized knowledge, so I really believe in knowledge. My educational background is in e-business. I'm currently doing my PhD in the subject of e-commerce. And I am co-founder and CEO of the leading e-commerce website in Macedonia that revolutionized the e-commerce market, Gruber.ng. So how I started Gruber, or how I became an entrepreneur, because to be honest, I have never dreamt to become an entrepreneur. But while I was studying at the university, I applied to every possible workshop that I could do to get more knowledge on different topics to see what I wanted to do. Then I was really competitive, so I attended a lot of competitions. I would get somewhere third prize, somewhere second place. I would win at drinking games even, because I was so competitive. And the prize that got me to open my company was actually this competition when I got first prize of the most innovative business plan. And when I say I got prize, I got funding. I know that a lot of digit number might come to your head, but it was a 5,000 euro prize. That seemed a lot at that time, so this was really an incentive to start my own company with two partners, which are, by the way, beautiful and men. because I'm here to speak about the challenges, I don't have much time I guess I will need 3 days to share the challenges that I have faced in the previous 5.5 years. But I would like to share with you a bit of the opportunity of how I have seen and discovered the opportunity to start a business. So when it comes to attitude toward opportunity, there are two types of people. One group is the ones that are endlessly waiting for an opportunity to come to them. So they sit and wait and they end up doing things that they don't want to do because they're too afraid to take risks. And then we have the other group of people, which are the ones that are creating the opportunities for themselves. So when it comes to creating opportunity in an emerging market, you might say that it is pretty difficult, maybe more difficult than a developed economy. But I would not agree. Maybe running a business is more difficult because the processes are not that smooth, we don't have a legal framework, we have some administrative burdens. But when it comes to opportunity, it is really simple and it's really easy. Because there are so many models, business models, that are proven and that work so well in developed countries, that we only have to discover, identify the market needs, and adopt those models to bring them on our market. So the innovation can be bringing a new model that is not existent in our country, so that's practically what we did. But however, in 2010, when we were starting Gruber, the opportunity was really shabby. Most of my friends with who I shared the idea, I'm going to do this, I'm going to change the e-commerce market in Macedonia, were like, yeah, you know, the market is not ready. This is not like more of an opportunity, but it's a problem. Because less than 1% of the population was buying online, the number of active payment cards were low. We are a society that highly relies on cash, so we would get our salary, get from the ATM, and then use cash to pay for things. Then there were security concerns. People did not have habit to buy online. But if you address these issues correctly, because Gruber is a daily website that offers high discounts and savings for people, if you really see this as an opportunity, I was not planning to address and offer the people convenience and saving time, and you won't wait in line, because you cannot do that in a country in a time of recession where people appreciate money over time. And so you won't get excited. You won't get people excited if you tell them you will save time and this is convenience. This offer convenience online buying. So we offer savings and high discounts, which we proved to beat all these other threats or limitations on the market. So we, after 5 years, or maybe after 2 years, I got a lot of calls from the press, from the mediums, and they told us recently we got a very good abbreviation, a game changer on the market of the e-commerce. So we really induced changes and we really changed the e-commerce market. And on the way of change, on the way of doing business, there are also a lot of things that have to be done. So again, maybe I'm labeling, but these are two groups of people as well. Most of you, I guess, will find it the second group. So when it comes to doing things, there are two people according to perception of doing things or the attitude toward doing things. These are the postponers, the first group. They have this box in their mind, like an empty box. And there are things that you have to do, but you keep piling them in the box. So I will do this tomorrow, and as you keep piling and piling and piling things in the box, then the more you start to hate those things, and you're like, oh, this is so stupid, I have to do these things. I don't like to do these things. And you keep complaining to yourself and complaining to other people that there are things that you cannot do. Oh, at work, you know, I have to do some reports. So you keep complaining and complaining, and the box is piling, and you lose one time, and time is really precious. And then we have the other group of people, which are the doers. They don't think too much. They don't have the box. They don't need the box. They just this needs to be done. Okay, get it done. I'll do it. I know how to do it. I'll learn how to do it. That's not a problem. So these are the doers, and I encourage you more if you found yourself in the first. If you have this box, just throw it up. The empty box for the postponers. And there will be obstacles on the way. So this big stone, I will use it metaphorically as a stone, but it can be anything standing on the way. So it can be marketing issue, something that is not familiar to you. It can be a legal issue. We had problems with the law of e-commerce, so I was really excited when I got an email 5 months ago that they're changing the law for e-commerce after 2 years lobbying. So there will be obstacles, but let's just for a second take this stone as it is a stone. So you have to pass through the stone, and if you want to pass through the stone, you have to, I don't know, dig a hole, or maybe you can climb it, or maybe you have some friends that work in construction and they will come and help you, or maybe you have some strong friend that will come and push the stone. So whatever it is that you have to pass the stone. And if the stone is not here, if there is not an obstacle, then I am sure that this path that you're going doesn't lead anywhere. So let's say you don't have friends. You don't have friends who work in construction, you don't have strong friends, you cannot do a call, so the only thing that you can do is to climb the stone. But you're not a climber. So I guess what you have to do is be really quick, be fast learner, go and take lessons for climbing, come back and climb the stone. So that's the metaphor in business and in applies as well. If there is something that you don't know how to do, just learn how to do it and do it. Because learning new things, after you overcome the stone, you might say, I don't need to know how to climb. But when you come over the stone, you will be more self-confident, as was mentioned before. And you will be more knowledgeable. And this thing that you will learn, you might apply to another field, which you will need tomorrow. So if there's a takeaway from my talk today, I really hope that it is the following things that you will take. Embrace knowledge every minute, every hour, every second of the day, everywhere, and don't isolate yourself from things that you hear and you're not interested at the moment, because you're more interested to not think about anything. So embrace knowledge everywhere, because you will really need it and you will apply it in another field maybe. Don't sit and wait for an opportunity, create an opportunity. So I'm here because I created the opportunity to talk to you. I was speaking this year to about 20 events, but I wasn't invited to speak to this event. But I'm like really excited for e-commerce, and I saw this story at 2025. We had a sent me a message on LinkedIn, and I said, oh, are they going to talk for e-commerce? Let me check. And I'm checking the agenda, and I'm like, oh, they're not going to talk about e-commerce, so it's not in the agenda. But then I got a call to go to Geneva and discuss the Act 8 for e-trade in February about the emerging countries, how e-commerce will be developed. So I was really happy. But I wasn't invited. Here's my message. Biljana, hello. I really congratulate you about this event. Is an e-commerce going to be the topic? And by the way, I'm Mina, I'm this and this and this and this and this, so maybe you can include me somewhere there. And she said, yes, we want to include you, and we will be delighted to have you talk here. So thank you very much for that invitation.
Thank you for creating the opportunity.
So third point is be self-confident but modest. Be self-confident but modest. Why am I saying this? Because I see lots of people who are overwhelmed with self-confidence, but are like empty boxes. They're not even the postponer box, but they're the empty box. So if you want to be self-confident, you have to really be knowledgeable. But then again, it's really good to be modest and invest in yourself, because as was mentioned, talent comes naturally, but skills can be developed only with hours and hours and hours of working on yourself. And last but not least, be fearless and use your potential. Use your potential to the maximum. Don't spare your brain, your memory. Don't spare yourself at all. Just use your potential to the maximum. And my final message, if you want to do something, then work for it and do it. If you want to be successful, then be successful, regardless if it's opening your company or getting a promotion in the company that you're working for or whatever it is. Thank you. Thank you.
Philip Misowski is coming from Sub Germany. He's going to speak about creating an innovative IT company in Macedonia that can sell globally. Thank you for joining us, Philip.
Hi everyone, can you guys hear me? Okay, so I heard there are a lot of high school or college students coming from Kochagin. Is that correct? Raise your hands. All right, awesome. So that's my alma mater. Actually, I dropped out of there. I was in high school for 2 years and I dropped out. I'll tell you a story about that. But actually, the story of mine, you know, I'm a technologist like the previous colleague from Oracle. I typically were like, you know, good at creating software and selling boring enterprise software, maybe not as good as a presenter. So I'll try to be 5 minutes so you know how much I would suck, you know, and then you can, you know, take a break or something like that. But the story that I'm going to talk about is through my personal experiences. It's not going to be about what we're going to talk about on Friday, which is literally about the opportunity that we have here with entrepreneurs and young folks and even established companies. It's actually going to be my personal story, my personal introduction of, you know, why am I here, why am I sitting in front of you. And it's actually about 2 points. It's about success and about failure. Now, you never hear about failure. Yeah? All the successful people that will come up, you know, like you've seen a lot of them. But a lot of that behind them is a lot of failures, including myself. I love to talk about this failure as well. And the success part, I'm going to talk about how to disrupt yourself. And we'll talk about the term of disruption. And the failure part, we'll talk about the fears. I have a fear of public speaking. I have fear actually.